We're going to use a unfinished DIY CNC machine to make these aluminum plates to fill the void of where those fans are supposed to go.
So a quick tram. Drilling operation. I'm just spotting the holes here. So I had my height set wrong and I couldn't figure out why it kept wanting to go down in the Z before traveling to where the hole placement was. So I figured I could just spot the holes and then drill them again with the drill them later in a drill press, or in my case a milling machine. And my first tool change, 4 flute, 1/4 inch high-speed steel, cheapo end mill. And I know 4 flutes aren't good for this type of application, but I wanted to use cheap end mills for the reasons of me always crashing my CNC machine. So again, with the Z height, not sure why it wants to travel over there, and doing a 2D pocket. And for some reason, I couldn't figure out why it was starting so high, and I should have just remembered that it likes to interpolate in. Using WD-40 at first, trying that out. I also tried vacuuming. Later, just switched to just pure air, with occasionally a little bit of WD-40. It wasn't long before the 4-flute started to cause me issues. That one gummed up, and you could see when I sprayed with the W40 that it just missed it out, that W40 from it being hot. Starting in the second pocket. This one is a rectangular hole, and it did fairly well. I don't think I really gummed up any end mills on this. Paused it there so I could let the air compressor catch up and blow some air on it and cool it off a little bit. I did another 2D pocket. I did one deeper, and then this one I'm taking off the stock to leave, and it left actually a really nice surface finish on the interior of these pockets. So then I drilled through the remainder of the wood so I could use some clamps to hold the material down more. And I went for almost a full depth cut on that, and that obviously was just too much of a load for the router. Trying it again over there, thought maybe a different area would work better, but it didn't work. Cleaning off the gummed up aluminum. So I actually tried a half inch 2-flute end mill, and it was doing really well. I was getting a fairly decent surface finish, hogging off some pretty good material. I'm going slow here to make sure I clear the clamp. And then, so I made a few passes like this, and it was working pretty well, I felt. Here, a little preview of the surface finish. Floor looked really good. So it's all 10 times sped up footage. This is real time right here, and I was filming with my phone so I could show the clearance that I could, that I was getting over the clamp. And all of a sudden it does that little step there, and then it does it again. And I wasn't quite sure what was happening. It seemed like everything was going fine except for those steps, and then I realized that it was off on the steps there and almost hogged in some pretty deep and would have messed up my part.
Just lost steps in the Y right axis, but not the left, so gonna have to figure that out, but I'm done for the night. Wasn't paying attention when I was yarding out and crashed my clamp.
And that was the result. It was a broken coupling. And luckily I had a new one. It was just the wrong diameter. So I drilled it out and reamered it to fit the servo.
So the flexion coupling for the Y-right axis broke. So I need to re-tram in the machine. And thankfully I have this machined surface here to work off of, so I could get it back into the same tram that it was in when I started this project.
Another quick tram, and I was just spinning the ball screw with my hand, and it was working out really well. So going back to the quarter inch end mill, and it was going to be 50 passes. Thankfully some of the half inch end mill cleaned off some, and so I skipped a bunch towards the beginning of it to get further down. Moving to the backside, reductive, and here I'm skipping through lines to get to where I would actually be cutting. Well, I wasn't cutting there, but first 10 passes or so. And a 2D contour to clean up the edges. It's supposed to be full depth. You can kind of really see here that either my gantry isn't true with the table, or the table has the table does have, you know, variations in it. It's not extremely flat like I was hoping it would be. Partly maybe potentially my fault. And a 2D adaptive with avoidance areas around the two clamps on the ends. And at this point, where it comes back in, you can see some height difference in the Z. Thankfully, I didn't realize it, but I had a stock to leave on here, so there was actually an axial stock to leave in this operation. And over here, it's just cutting air. Here, I'm just parting off that extra wood that's on the north side of the plate there. And then 2D contour on the sides where the clamps were. And at this point, I decided to bore out a half-inch hole in that, and that was the whole operation. It worked a lot better than the 2D pocket operation. And then I tried a 2D contour to split the part in half. It didn't like it because it's virtually a slot on the from south to north direction. So I decided to go to a 2D adaptive clearing at this point. It was a full depth cut, except for there's a little bit of material on the bottom. Then a 2D contour with a negative stock to leave. The surface finish actually turned out pretty good on this operation. And there's that cricket. So I decided to make a fixture to fix the all the parts. Make sure they're good. I split the whole project in half, and then when they were in half, I cut them in half again with a saw. So I did a 2D adaptive clearing on the top. I had the left radial stock to leave on this operation. And then I would come in with a 2D contour with no stock to leave, just to clean up the outside profile a little bit. And then a 2D contour on the north side there to clean up the saw cut. I would do those operations on all four pieces, and then I would spot the four corner holes. Then I would just finish drilling the holes on the mill. Tapped them 832, and that's them installed in the cabinet.
So with the router, I'm kind of limited to, I only have half inch and a quarter inch collet in for the router head. So that was limiting me on the end mills I could use. I had ordered those specifically, those four flute cheapo end mills, and I wanted to use those because I do tend to crash things quite a bit. So they were the cheapest quarter inch shank end mill I could find, and they, other than gumming up, they did good on profiling the outsides of stuff, but as far as plunging and stuff like that, they boring in, they weren't doing so great. So these are, they go in my Bidmark computer cabinets to fill the fan holes, and I designed them with this recess so this would fit in there perfectly. In all reality, I could have went with a completely flat plate, four holes in the corner, and three different individual holes in the center. But I thought they'd be a lot cooler like that, and it turned out to be a bunch more work. In reality, I should have just cut my material at like 5.5 inches or so, and prevented me from having to do so much machining. It did take quite a bit of time with that quarter inch end mill to get that stuff. The half inch was doing good, but when I was after I broke the coupling and was moving my head out, I wasn't paying attention, and I hit that clamp and broke that end mill, or chipped the corner of it. I did pick up a $8 mister and air blaster, so that's going to be probably the first attachment next project that I do on this machine. I've had a lot of ideas on how to make this machine stiffer or more rigid, and just not working on the machine at all. I just haven't got around to getting those projects done. So with that, thanks for watching, and please subscribe.